slavery, when black people like me talk to the slaves, they didn't kill them. They sent some old house Negro along behind him to undo what he said. You have to read the history of slavery to understand this. There were two kinds of Negroes. There was that old house Negro and the field Negro. And the house Negro always looked out for his master. When the field Negroes got too much out of line, he held them back in check. He put them back on the plantation. And he lived in a better house. He lived right up next to his master in the attic or the basement. And he loved his master more than his master loved himself. If the master got sick, he'd say, "What's the matter, boss? We sick?" He never wanted his master's property threatened. And he was more defensive of it than the master was. That was the house Negro. And today you still have house Negroes and field Negroes. Yeah.
What Semitism is, religions, and my response would be, it's not about educating yourself on what Semitism is and what anti-Semitism is. It's really about learning the root words of where these come from and understanding that this is an African heritage that is also belonging to the people. Africa is in it, whether we want to dismiss it or not. So the claims of anti-Semitism and who are the original chosen people of God, and we go into these religious conversations and it's a big no-no. I don't live my way like that. I don't live my life that way. Excuse me, I grew up in a melting pot, and I say a melting pot of all races, white, black, red, yellow, Jewish, Christian, Muslim, and you can see the way I live my life now. I'm not here to be divisive, so they could push their agenda. I don't want to say they, because I'm not identifying any one group or race of people, but I'm in a unique position to have a level of influence on my community, and what I post does not mean that I support everything that's being said or everything that's being done or I'm campaigning for anything. All I do is post things for my people and my community and those that it's actually going to impact. Anybody else that has criticism, it obviously wasn't meant for them.
Hopefully I'm understanding what you said, and I want to make sure I get it right because I don't want to misquote any part of it.
I don't expect understanding from a media conglomerate group that sincerely talks about the game of basketball and then we bring up religion as if it's correlative at times when it's convenient for people to bring it up. So please just be direct with your question, right, so we can move on from this and I can talk about the game and go home to my son Elohim and my wife Marlene, okay?
Am I to take it that this was what you shared was not something that you've even watched? This was, you did, okay, you did watch it, or either watch it or read it.
I had a lot of time to read a lot. Read a whole bunch. Good and bad about the truth of our world.
So then do you, I guess, understand or not understand those that might imply that that work had anti-Semitic leanings in it? I only ask this because the tweet is still up there, so I
presume. We're in 2022. It's on Amazon, a public platform. Whether you want to go watch it or not is up to you. There's things being posted every day. I'm no different than the next human.
Surprised that I did hurt people?
Are you surprised that reaction and some of the things that you did hurt people?
Yeah, I think I can ask a better question. It's just, where were you when I was a kid figuring out that 300 million of my ancestors are buried in America? Where were you guys asking those same questions when I was a kid dealing with learning about the traumatic events of my familial history and what I'm proud to come from? And why I'm proud to stand here, and why, when I repeat myself that I'm not going to stand down, it has nothing to do with dismissing any other race or group of people. I'm just proud of my heritage and what we've been through. and the fact that this has pinned me against the Jewish community. And I'm here answering questions of whether or not I'm sorry or not on something I didn't create. And it was something I shared, and I'm telling everybody I'm taking responsibility, then that's where I sit. So, you know, these same questions that you guys ask, me dealing with it as being a melanated, pigmented person all around the world and dealing with racial biases against my skin color, demeaning me because of my religious beliefs, and I'm still sitting in the seat standing. So, I take my full responsibility. Again, I'll repeat it, for posting something on my Instagram or Twitter that may have had some unfortunate falsehoods in it. But I also am a human being that's 30 years old, and I've been growing up in a country that's told me that I wasn't worth anything, and I came from a slave class, and I come from a people that are meant to be treated the way we get treated every day. So I'm not here to compare anyone's atrocities or tragic events that their families have dealt with generations of time. I'm just here to continue to expose things that our world continues to put in darkness. I'm a light. I'm a beacon of light. That's what I'm here to do. You guys ask me questions about basketball, I give you my expert opinion. You guys ask me about other things, I give you my opinion, and it's met with whatever you believe the perception or the deception is. You guys investigate my life every day, and you justify it by serving your own purpose, which I honor. I would like the same respect in return, figuring out just like anyone else. So please keep that same energy when we're talking about anti-other things, because just because I posted a documentary doesn't mean I'm anti-Semitic, and doesn't mean that I'm automatically standing with everyone that is believing in that. So it's unfortunate timing that we're in, but I'm glad that I could stand on the truth, because I'm not afraid of these mics, these cameras. I used to be looking everyone in the eye and telling them the truth, and I'm proud of who I am. Any label that you put on me, I'm able to dismiss because I study. I know the Oxford Dictionary, you look it up, right? Just one of the biggest mistakes I had in being a kid was not knowing European or Western language until I started looking it up and understanding the definitions and why they say, if you want to trick a black person, put it in the book. I was wondering my whole life why they said that. Now I'm 30 years old and I know reading is a superpower, because it helps me understand where I'm going and where I come from. Like a tree with roots.
Kyrie, the documentary listed among falsehoods, it said the Holocaust didn't happen. Do you
Again,
believe the Holocaust
those falsehoods
happened?
Are unfortunate. And it's not that I don't believe in the Holocaust. I never said that. Never, ever have said it. It's not come out of my mouth. I never tweeted it. I never liked anything like it. So, the Holocaust in itself is an event that means something to a large group of people that suffered something that could have been avoided. No one said we had to practice racism. No one said we had to treat each other like garbage. No one said that I had to stand here today and understand that many people that come from generations 60 years ago, 40 years ago, enslaved some of my ancestors, still spiritually, mentally, and emotionally, and it's still going on. You guys are asking me, respectfully, to speak on something that was a documentary that I had nothing to do with. I didn't make it. So, just please keep that same energy when you guys are addressing me.
Kyrie, for the record, do you have any anti-Semitic beliefs?
Again, I'm going to repeat. I don't know how the label becomes justified, because you guys ask me the same questions over and over again. But this is not going to turn into a spin-around cycle of questions upon questions. I told you guys how I felt. I respect all walks of life and embrace all walks of life. That's where I sit.
I think what people want to hear, though, is just a yes or no on that question. Yes or no.
I cannot be anti-Semitic if I know where I come from. I cannot be anti-Semitic if I know where I come from.
Kyrie, did you personally meet with the ADL?
I was informed that they wanted to have a meeting.
hesitation when I read the press release, number one, to address the accusation of what the reporter said to Kyrie Irving, and now that's being circulated, that he doesn't believe that the Holocaust exists, right? And for me, I believe and I feel that that should have been the very first thing that was addressed inside the press release, right? The first thing that should have been addressed is making it clear what do you feel about the Holocaust. It's pretty simple. Just, hey, you know what? If it was me writing a press release, if it was done on myself, if I was in that position, I would have had the lawyers and I would have had, you know, the PR. We would have made it clear my stance on the Holocaust. I would have made it clear stating that the Holocaust existed. You know, in the sources that is presented, is not to discredit it from a perspective of stating that the Holocaust did not exist, because hey, the sources are there to show that the Holocaust did exist, right? But he should have put in there the stance stating that the Holocaust do exist or did happen, you know, and then whatever historical information he's sharing on it, share sources like he normally do. But I believe that the first thing that should have started off with is bringing the discussion to him and away from Kyrie Irving. You know, for me, I would have brought all the smoke. If I was in the position, I would have brought all the smoke towards me. I would have started off by making it clear that Kyrie Irving should not be held accountable for the works that he did. That would have been the first thing. The second thing I would have pointed out, I would have addressed the Holocaust, right? I would have made it clear my stance on the Holocaust, right? Not giving any room for assumptions, right? And I want to say peace and blessings to my sister Shonda. No, Kyrie Irving, that video that they're referring to, actually Kyrie Irving even made it clear. I got a video that Kyrie Irving says he's not retiring. Someone put that out there. Kyrie Irving never said that he was considering retiring. He do have a video making it clear that he's not considering retiring, right? But that's the video I saw was based upon the whole thing that happened with the COVID situation. But anyway, I'm just talking about the Ron Dalton thing for those that are coming in. And I want to make this clear. And I'm going to have to put up disclaimers because, and it's unfortunately that we have to put up disclaimers, especially when we have to talk about information. But there's a reason why you see the disclaimers that says, especially if you're interviewing someone or you're using certain materials, that from a historical perspective, that you have to be clear by stating that the thoughts and belief of the writer or the source of this publication, you know, their views, right, are not a reflection of what we believe. I'm gonna make that clear. The thoughts, views, and opinions of Ronald Dalton or in all the sources that I use does not reflect the thoughts, the views, and the beliefs of We Woke Now and of Passion for Reconciliation. And the reason why I'm stating that is because, again, when I read that press release, it left a lot of meat on the bones. And I want to make it clear that We Woke Now, we don't teach that the Holocaust did not happen, right? I use sources to talk, to discuss, like the actual numbers, for example, of Auschwitz, and I use Poland Jews, a Polish argument that was on Times, New York Times, right, that states that the number, as far as the number of victims, went from 4 million on the tablets to 1.5 million on the tablets, right? And I know where anti-Semitism, according to the legalities, is when you start dealing with what is believed to be exaggerations of the Holocaust. It's considered anti-Semitism. So that's why I show sources, right? So for me, I would have, if I was in Ronald Dalton's position, he should have went directly at Rolling Stones and called out the actual lies that Rolling Stones pointed out, starting with stating that he is saying that all the Jews are the starting point of the transatlantic slave trade. He in this press release, he should have addressed these things. Ron Dalton, I read his book, you know, I've met him, right, in the past, right? I've met him, and he's a very sharp guy. He's a very educated guy. And family, I believe, right? This is why you have certain people do certain things. Because I'm a geek, and sometimes from being a geek, I may not, my words that I have in my head may not come across in the way that I think it or wanted to project. So that's why we have, you know, different people to help make sure that we are able to articulate certain things that we have up in our brain. And I'm sure you guys have done it before, that you said something, you had a thought, but when you tried to express yourself, it did not come out the way that you wanted to express or wanted to say. So you wanted to go back and give clarity on it. I was waiting for that inside this press release, and I'm hoping that Ronald Dalton do a follow-up to this press release and answer those questions. You know, go to and put the onus on and hold accountable the Rolling Stones, the writer of that article.